the approval and trust ratings of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. slide ahead of his State of the Nation address. RG Cruz has more.
Less than a week before President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. delivers his third State of the Nation address, Pulse Asia Research bears the results of its June 17 to 24 nationwide poll of 2,400 respondents, showing the president's trust and approval ratings down slightly from the previous quarter, while still enjoying the trust and approval of the majority. The 2-point decline of Mr. Marcos Jr.'s approval rating is within the margin of error. Mr. Marcos has majority approval everywhere except in Mindanao and Class ABC. Vice President Sara Duterte, meanwhile, kept her 71% trust rating and improved her approval rating from 67% to 69%. The poll was taken the same time she announced her departure from the Marcos Jr. cabinet, which she served as Secretary of Education. She enjoyed majority approval and trust ratings across the board. The President's cousin, House Speaker Martin Romualdez's trust and approval ratings were marginally up, though he is the only top national leader with no majority trust or approval rating. Romualdez enjoys majority trust and approval ratings only in his home region of Visayas. Romualdez also suffered double-digit, undecided distrust and disapproval ratings. New Senate President Francis Escudero enjoyed a 69% trust rating, earning the nod of the majority across the board. The Senate chief credited the Senate for his numbers.
Well, taus-puso po kaming nagpapasalamat sa tiwalang binibigay sa amin, hindi lamang sa akin, pero sa institusyon ng Senado na kinabibilangan ko. Pero tulad ng ibang survey, tataas yan, bababa yan. Kung mataas man yan, inspirasyon yan para sa amin. Kung mababa man yan, edo aral na pwedeng aral at leksyon na pwedeng pagpulutan namin yan para magsumika pa.
Pulse Asia says that at the national level, public opinion about the quarterly performance of the President, the Vice President, and the Speaker hardly changed from March to June. The Senate President's performance rating was not taken as he is new to the job. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Vice President Sara Duterte insists there's no need for her to clarify why she called herself the designated survivor as she skips next week's sauna. The term is used in the U.S. to refer to a cabinet official who sits out the president's State of the Union address and will lead the government if a catastrophic event kills the country's top leaders in that occasion. Duterte claims she meant it in all seriousness, but denies it was meant as a warning of possible threats to the event.
Dili to siya joke, dili po to siya bang threat. I think many missed the point. So, para sa ko, kung wala ka kasabot the first time, I don't think you deserve an explanation.
Manila Congressman Joel Chua files a bill that proposes a designated survivor protocol similar to that of the U.S. government. The Presidential Succession Act of 2024 proposes an alternative to the Philippine constitutional line of succession should the designated successors be unable to serve in acting capacity. Chua's bill designates the Chief Justice as the caretaker of the executive branch if both offices of the President and Vice President are left vacant. He believes the Chief Justice should be the designated survivor because of the respect the position commands. The Philippines and China arrange a new hotline mechanism that will involve the presidential offices of the two countries. A communication channel will be opened between top diplomats, and representatives designated by the presidents of the two countries to prevent any new confrontation in the West Philippine Sea. But maritime experts doubt the effectiveness of the new deal, citing Beijing's unresponsiveness to the previously established direct line of communication.
When we called them up on several incidents, they did not answer. So they will answer only at the time of their choosing. So it's useless.
The actions of the Chinese Coast Guard, the maritime militia, and of course the People's Liberation Army is actually being directed from Beijing. Mm-hmm. So what's the point of a hotline? If actually what's happening is, of course, what I would call a coordinated, very sophisticated maritime expansion.
The latest development is part of efforts to de-escalate tensions at sea following last month's tense encounter in Ayungin Shoal that resulted in a Filipino soldier losing his thumb. The Philippine Coast Guard says China's monster ship is still in Philippine waters, contrary to the previous report of the Philippine Navy. PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore J. Tariala, says the ship was still anchored near Escuadra Shoal and has not departed since July 3rd. Maritime security expert Ray Powell believes the confusion over the location of the ship was probably because it moved outside the reef for 3 days from July 12 to 15. Aside from the monster, the PCG also monitored the presence of a 135-meter Chinese Coast Guard ship, which has been sailing near Lubang Island in Occidental Mindoro over the past few days. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina, and good morning to all. So at 3 a.m. today, the low-pressure area was estimated based on all available data in the vicinity of Catbalogan City, Samar. Due to this low-pressure area, expect a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Visayas, Bicol region, Caraga, Marinduque, and Romblon. Expect also a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Cagayan, Isabela, Quirino, Aurora, Bulacan, Laguna, Rizal, and Quezon due to the drop of the low pressure area. On the other hand, the southwest monsoon continues to affect the western section of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Due to this, expect also a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Metro Manila, Bataan, Zamboanga Peninsula, Bangsamoro, northern Mindanao, and the rest of Calabarzon and Mimaropa. For the rest of our country, expect a generally fair weather with a high chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest here in PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel.